Hello!
Christopher Andrew. How are you doing?
Purchased this while we visited America. Purchased it for many reasons. For the name, for the image, and for the contents. This will be my first ever mead. Now, Andrew's a fan of the Evil Dead series, and he actually has the Evil Dead in a special book kind of thing.
The case looks like the book Evil Dead. Yeah.
So I purchased this for $6.67.
We've got all your taping on it.
Yeah.
That's the what do you put that tape on for?
Oh, just so this we could. It could last longer for the trip, because
across the pond, yeah.
Yeah, because we're flying all the way from America to the UK to Yorkshire. It smells like lavender and it smells like
potpourri.
Yeah. Yeah, it smells like potpourri.
Is it French terminology, isn't it? Is it?
Can I breathe a little bit?
Pour some in there and it'll breathe in there.
There's no smell of it. There's no smell of it for you. It smells nice. Are you going to pour it? Yeah, I purchased this in the US over here from B. Nectar.
You get a bit of a blossom there smell. A bit of a swirl.
Put a little bit more in.
Just a little bit.
The ABV on this is 6%. Now, one of the other reasons I purchased this is because it has mango and black pepper honey wine, which is what mead is. It's like a honey wine.
Yeah. Do you get honey there?
Oh, you definitely get only from bottle or anything else.
I get more of a blossom there, sort of like yeah. You know, flowers and sort of.
That's what the early days of.
I suppose. Quite, you know, the sort of stuff that you'd spare your room with.
Now, mead is very expensive no matter where you go, whether you're in the Yorkshire, we do our own mead and such, or America. $6.67, that's probably about £4 something sterling.
Mm.
But anyway, cheers. Tastes like. Definitely get a honey straight away.
Mm.
Definitely get that potpourri taste on the palate. It tastes like medicine. Like I'm supposed to be eating medicine. I've not had mead before, so I can't have anything to compare it to. But it has been sitting a while. I was hoping to share this with Rob Derbyshire and others. Because they've got more broadened palate. Get a little bit of cedar wood. Definitely, you get a little bit of lemon barley.
Just a bit like rosy, like sort of almost like Turkish delight.
Mm.
So you know that sort of.
Yeah, I can say with Turkish delight.
Mm. Yeah, Turkish delight.
I'm not eating mangoes, but again, it's a new experience for me.
I mean, if you had to think of mangoes and then drink that, you'd probably almost quite imagine mangoes in there. But it's the fact that I can't get the pepper. What else? Honey. But I don't know. Maybe because of too much sweetness, it's just counted each other out.
But there you go. I don't think you get any attention on these kind of beers or these kind of meads. I think David Dowling has done a lot of meads.
Really? calls himself the Viking, so... The smell on it is sort of dulled down a bit now.
In fairness, on the palate, it kind of improves. Mm.
Quite easy to drink as well.
Yeah, salt. Which is 6%.
It's like having some sort of flavoured rosé water. And it is quite flavoursome.
Yeah.
Quite easy to drink. And
would at $6, £4? Yeah, because of that uniqueness and the presentation and stuff like that.
But now I'm getting a bit of an apple taste afterwards. Do you get an apple taste afterwards?
Oh, yeah. Get a little bit of apple.
Well, you like apple core, sort of.
But would you buy it again? I'd buy it again.
Yeah, I suppose.
And what it is, because it is slowly introduced us into meads, I would actually try more meads now. I think one of the local ones for us is Lindisfarne. They do some meads here in the UK. But it's inspired me to try more meads, which is always a good thing that a beer or a mead should do. Basically, inspire you to try more. Presentation's awesome. History on this is awesome. Check out... I'll try and get... Pause it when you can.
Probably can be backwards. It looks like backwards to us.
But yeah, check it out. Definitely try it out. Always try something different, just to broaden your palate. Even from with drinkers like lagers, late bloomers, stuff like that. Even if you're into ciders and stuff like that. It's nice, easy, palatable, and inspires you to try more.
The mango's almost coming out now, almost.
I'm guessing the more it warms, the more flavours will pop out. Check out the Necromangocon. Yeah, my first ever mead, and put me off. It's just inspired me to try more.
There you go.
You take care.
Goodbye.